James will receive.
Welcome to the Cadet Student Network's broadcast of CBC Football. The Tim Kilo broadcast booth is on the road this week as the Cadets meet the Jays of Jefferson City High School here at Atkins Stadium. This is an incredible facility and we're excited to bring you football from the state capital. I'm class of 2014 graduate Jack Hummel and I'm joined in the booth by Patrick Walsh. Big win for the Cadets in week one. What do you think of the team's performance?
The Cadets really came out strong, Jack. It's first, before we get rolling, it's great to have you back. Class of 2014 alum Jack Hummel with us tonight, taking a break from his second week of college at Mizzou to come down here to Jeff City and spend some time with us. But yeah, Jack, to the point of your question, the Cadets played incredibly well last week. They introduced a new hurry-up offense, really fast pace, snapping the ball within 5 or 6 seconds of the whistle blowing and the play clock rolling every play. It was an exciting brand of football, and it worked last week, obviously. Great results, wound up winning 63-14 over the Hickman Cupies.
And the Cadets will defend first here with Caleb Meinsner kicking off first, and here we go.
Caleb had a great week last week. 8 out of 9 or 9 out of 10 touchbacks, if memory serves. Whole new week this week, though. We'll see how it goes.
And the Cadets will kick off. And it'll be back into the end zone.
Just as I predicted, Jack. What do you think? First call of the night. I think I'll stop from here.
I think you might as well. Sounds good.
It's a lovely night here at Atkins Stadium. A little cool. Still warm out, but cooler than last week. Hopefully we don't have the same water breaks, heat delays as we did last week. And we're starting right on time here, just after 7 o'clock. Exciting night for football under the lights.
And the Jays will start at the 20-yard line. Quarterback Gunner C will start for the Jefferson Jays. At the 20, but there's a fumble.
Ball was down. Looked like the ground caused that fumble. Another good punt return by Mike Million. He had a 70-yard punt return for a touchdown last week. The kid's really racking up the yards here in the first 2 weeks of the season.
And he's been a strong player for the Cadets even when I was there. Obviously, as myself being an upperclassman and Mike as an underclassman, was always a player that we looked to, obviously, for performance and to get us those extra yards. So the Cadets will start here at the 20. Quarterback Blake Charlton. And number 4.
That's Kalen Taylor right up the gut.
And Kalen Taylor, who last season had almost 1,000 yards, number 4 running back, is definitely a key player for the Cadets tonight, I think.
Absolutely. The coach, Scott Pingle, and his offense, they're going to roll through 3 or 4 different tailbacks tonight. Kalen's just as important as any of them.
And here he is again, and he will make a run for it, and he's taken down right past the 10-yard line.
Looks like a first down, Cadets. It'll be first and goal. Kalen Taylor recently committed to play at the United States Military Academy up at West Point.
The Cadets here.
Taylor runs right, knocked down at the 15.
Tackle by Booker.
And right now the Cadets are looking pretty good. It looks like that long summer of hard work has really kind of paid off for these guys.
These guys worked incredibly hard through the summer. A lot different than back when I was playing. They were hard at work all of June and July.
And Charlton will pass to number 9. That is Lamar Anderson. And they will be right at the 5, right before the 5-yard line.
Third and goal here at the 5, maybe the 6. Good job by Charlton to pull that one back and hit Anderson on that quick slant over the middle. You know, all those run plays, stretch them right, stretch them left. You'll get some room over the middle.
Third down here, and the Cadets will try to convert here, and it is going to be a touchdown.
That's number 8, Trey Bryan, I believe.
That's a good start for CBC right there.
Great first drive. You know, the one negative play there, but they were able to overcome it with a quick slant over the middle and then a Trey Bryant rush for a score.
And the Cadets will lead the Jefferson Jays 6-0 with 9:10 on the clock.
Caleb Meinzer and his big right foot out there to kick the extra point.
A former soccer player.
Is that right?
It is. And it's denied, so the Cadets will.
Charlton got a lot of time at the end of the year last year. Jack Even, a senior quarterback, is also getting some snaps. All those guys have a lot of experience, but we did lose a lot up front in your senior class, Jack. Guys like Tim Gant, Brian Wallace. Who am I forgetting there? There's a guard in the center. But those guys are off to college now, and we've got some younger guys who were able to gain some experience on the second team last year. Guys like Max Durrell. John Chamberlain is the one holdover. He's a three-year starter now on the offensive line. And those guys have gelled incredibly well if the first four and a half quarters of the season are any indication, especially picking up this hurry-up offense. It's a lot of hand signals. The guys have to be mentally and physically sharp throughout the game, and they're playing incredibly well.
And Mines are here with the kickoff. And he'll send it right to the end zone.
Booms it deep again, and not only was that into the end zone, that's also deep left, far to the left of the field, close to the sideline, really cuts down the tackling angles for our kick cover team. That's a great kick.
Most definitely. And the Jefferson Jays will start here at the 20-yard line. Again, quarterback Gunner C. And he'll fake the handoff there, and he's taken down right before the 24-yard line.
Mike Jones on the tackle for the Cadet. Ball spotted at the 23, second and seven.
And the Jays at the 23-yard line right now.
Looks like we have number 99, Gatewood, in at nose guard now, rolling through some different defensive linemen. It'll be a fast-paced game, so look for a lot of subs.
He'll look to number 18, Ripken Dodson.
Dodson was wide open on the right side of the field for that offense. You know, the Cadets are looking into the backfield. It's been predominantly a run attack by the Jays so far. Gunner C pulled that one back and found Dodson for a nice game.
And here's C again. There's a flag on the play.
Moving a little early.
So the Cadets will gain a little bit of ground here.
Moving back, first and 15.
The ball on the 37-yard line. And a handoff, and he's taken down right at the 40-yard line. A helmet knocked off there.
That'll be second and 12. It looks like I don't see Damian Baker out there, one of the top players in the St. Louis area, one of our best cover corners. Went out with a foot injury last week. I don't see him out on the field tonight, so we may be without Damian.
I believe he was sidelined today. I saw him warming up others, I should say.
He'll be sitting out. Hopefully Damian's not hurt too bad, and we get him back here quickly.
Cadets definitely look to him this season.
Both on offense and defense, he's a two-way starter for us. Caught a lot of balls on the offensive side of the field last year as well. All around great kid too.
And C will start on his own 47-yard line.
Important third down here.
And a handoff to number 23, and he's taken down by number 44. Quentin Wine, yet again.
Quentin Wynn. I think it's Wynn, buddy. You must not have known him back in your days on campus.
Mispronunciation, no. Never came in contact through the halls.
Well, if you had, he may have tackled you. Quentin Wynn is a sack machine.
No kidding.
He and Kevin Williams on the other side of that defensive line, had big weeks last week.
And the Jays will kick off to the Cadets.
Boy, beautiful punts here. Who's this kid?
And here's Mike Million, and he'll try to beat the defense, and he's taken back quite a bit, and there's a fumble. Yet again, and the Jays will recover it at what looks like.
Jays cover that at about the 12-yard line.
12 yards.
We were just talking about Mike Million singing his praises. He's had some big returns this year. May have been trying to do a little too much with that high spiraling punt. You know, the hang time on that punt gave the cover team a lot of time to get down there, get close to Mike Million. And
there's a little bit of hesitation there.
That's right.
I think on which direction he was going to take it.
You know, I like got to be back there, stand tough, not call too many fair catches, but sometimes you just got to do it.
So the Jays here, and he'll be taken down, I believe, right at the 10-yard line.
Tackled by number 44, Quinton Wynn. Ball down to the cadet's 10-yard line.
Quinton Wynn again on the tackle. Seven. Gatewood, the junior nose guard, is causing a lot of havoc in there. Both he and Miles Taylor look to be sharing time at that position. Playing incredibly well.
The Jays will try to run it, but they're taken down again at the 10. The Cadets doing a pretty good job of holding them here, obviously after that loss of yardage.
This could be a big stand for the defense. You know, really demoralize the Jays if they can't use the momentum of that turnover to push it into the end zone.
Again, that strong Cadet defense that's really kind of held this team together so far this game.
I think it was 18, Sean Boyden on that tackle, the safety. Sean had a great year last year and a good week last week.
And a penalty here.
Tell you who else I'm impressed with, Jack, is number 61, Jordan Davis. I don't know if Jordan's a junior or a senior. The roster shows that he's a senior. He's coming in to spell both of the defensive end positions. He played very well last week. Number of tackles. Let's see what the stat sheet shows us. 5.5, I believe. And a sack. Kids
Here's
really
the Jays
making an
here.
Impact.
And they're taken down again.
Speak of the devil, I think that's Jordan Davis. Some of the Cadets were calling, signaling as though there were a fumble on that play.
We'll see here. And the Cadets look like their celebration, it looks like they got it.
CBC ball.
Again, that defense right there to turn the Cadets around, which what we thought would be a Jays drive into the end zone.
How about that? Huge stop by the Cadet defense. Huge stop by the Cadet defense. The turnover on the 12-yard line, two running plays stalled right inside. They couldn't even get inside the five, and then a fumble on third down. Holds the Jays scoreless.
The Cadets will start it on their own 6-yard line here and hope to get the ball out of here.
Here comes that CBC offense. Huddle on the sideline, not on the field. We'll try it out here and run a play quickly, I'm sure.
And starter Blake Charlton will be in there again.
Kalen Taylor to his left. Two receivers out wide.
And here's Taylor. He'll look to break through, and it looks like he's taken down about the 6-yard line.
Give a little bit of breathing room there.
Cadets will slowly move their way out here. Charlton will run. Looks to about the 10-yard line.
Charlton's a big kid, and he's an athletic kid as well. He can run and. He'll punish a defender if the defender leaves himself open.
6'3", 190.
190.
Obviously a force out here.
Good baseball player as well, obviously with that that big arm.
And here he is again, and he's taken down about the 3-yard line. Travis Burr with the tackle there for the Jefferson Jays. To put the Cadets at the 4-yard line.
This will be a tight punt formation. We'll have Blake Charlton back to kick it. He did a good job punting the ball for us last week. Got to be careful when your heels are on that end line back there. Don't want to step
definitely.
Out of bounds and get a safety.
Charlton with the punt here.
Bit of a low wobbler, but no return.
They will start the 36. 4:42 left on the clock. The Cadets still leading 6-0.
Second consecutive drive here that the Jays will be inside. Start with the ball on the Cadets' side of the field. As we have a short break in play here, we want to say thanks to some of our sponsors, the first of which is the presenting sponsor of the Cadet Student Network. That's Tim Kylo. Tim is a Class of 77 alum and also a State Farm agent. Call Tim for all your insurance needs. I'll give you his number in just a second.
The Jays will try to make an offensive run here, and they're taken out at about the
get to about the 28. Nice little out route there. Good throw by Gunner. Tim's phone number, 314-842-4442, or send him an email, tim@timkylo.com. That's Tim, KILO.com.
Here's the Jefferson Jays here, and they'll try to make a run. And they're taken down about the 23-yard line. Number 26, Denzel Wilson. And Gunner C. will start at his own 26-yard line.
Bit of confusion there.
Complete pass there by C.
Had a couple of receivers running into each other. I was just about to comment on the positive momentum that the Jays have moving here. A couple good plays, get a first down, and looking to cause some trouble, but the receivers just weren't on the same page with Gunner on that one.
A little bit of confusion there on the right side. And they'll start at the 23-yard line. Here's C, and he'll shuffle back. Out to number 6. Jake Protigen, and he's taken down.
It's Eric Carrera there, another of our strong safeties. Good play. He didn't get lost with that misdirection. That looked like a design play. Pump fake right and roll back to his left. It was nice footwork by Gunner to get out of the pocket there and make a nice throw. Strong defense by Carrera to stay with that play, not get fooled.
He's really been a force for the Cadets. I mean,
he is. He's been a varsity guy since his freshman year, I believe.
He has. And obviously myself being an upperclassman, we always looked at Eric as a close friend of mine, always as a force on the field, not only as a player but as a leader as well. An all-around just great guy and obviously a force for the CBC Cadets.
He's also one of our student ambassadors at CBC. Does a lot of work with Mr. Jim Brockman, our director of admissions, showing potential students around campus. Eric is a good guy.
You can always find him with a shadow
That's
walking
right
through the halls.
Looks like we'll line up for a field goal here. As there was a big stop on third down by the Cadets on that run play.
And the Jays will go for an attempt here.
No good.
No good for the field goal attempt.
So again, the Cadet defense comes up big on that stop.
Holding down yet again, and they'll keep the score at 6-0 here with just over three left to play in the first quarter.
Jack, how's college treating you? You've only been there for about 10 days now, am I right?
Just finished my first week today. Can't complain. It's going well. Big football game tomorrow night.
Mm-hmm.
Mizzou obviously playing South Dakota State in their home opener, so I'll be at that. But overall, classes have been good, and can't complain. So.
All right, you haven't been sleeping too late yet.
No, never. Haven't slept through one yet. So
that's good.
Can't complain.
A lot of freedom once you get to college.
Definitely.
Make sure your self discipline is on point. You got to get up, get to class. But I know you're a hardworking guy, kind of an entrepreneurial guy. You've been running your own business for a few years here. You were a great help here on the Cadet Student Network during your days at CBC, so I would expect nothing less than perfect attendance.
Thank you very much.
Are you also involved, have you gotten involved in the broadcasting program in Columbia yet?
I have. I'm kind of getting my feet wet right now, starting with KOMU. I'm the local NBC affiliate and sort of working my way in through there. I'm also doing some stuff around the football team. I actually had a sit down the other day with starting quarterback Maddie Mock, which was very cool. We've kind of become somewhat close friends through this past summer in their training camp. So it's really been really been a privilege and just a lot of fun, so I'm enjoying it.
Good for you. Speaking of quarterbacks, it looks like Jack Even's in here for the third or fourth series of the game.
He is. Here's Even, and he'll hand it off to what I think was Miles Taylor. And he's taken down right at the 23-yard line.
Looks like eight, Trey Bryant's in there at running back. We're snapping it quick.
Here's Even to outside to Eric Carrera, and he's taken down right at the 30-yard line.
Looks like a cadet first down.
And talking about quarterbacks here, obviously we saw Blake Charlton in at the beginning and now Jack Even. But both quarterbacks have obviously proved themselves. Obviously there's only been two games, but within these two games that the opportunities they've been given, they've really taken full throttle and just kind of used every opportunity they have.
No, you're right. Kalen Taylor gets bottled up there. But the quarterbacks have both played well. I think they both put in a lot of work over the summer, both developing good leadership skills, worked hard with the team. And I think, Blake's getting a few more reps right now, but Jack's a solid high school quartererback as well with potential to go play in college. So it's nice that he's getting a chance as well.
And here he is right now. He'll look to go outside, and it's a little bit far.
Looks like he overthrew Kalen there. May not have had a solid grip on that ball before he let it go. That's one thing with rolling two quarterbacks through. Sometimes the second guy will get in there, either quarterback, the starter or the backup, and they'll feel like they need to prove themselves, do a little too much.
Most definitely. Here's Even again. And he will pass. And he's.
I believe that's Mike Million. But I was wrong. That's Kalen Taylor.
Taken down at the 46-yard line.
Move the chains. Now let's see how much time goes off the play clock here before the cadets are snapping it. Start at 25. We get a snap by 22. That's the new brand of cadet football.
It is. And here's Taylor. And he's taken down just past the 50-yard line.
Kalen Taylor running hard. I tell you what, as a former offensive lineman, I got a lot of respect for these big fellas, running a lot of stretch run plays, hustling back to the ball, and getting ready to snap it and go.
They're certainly working for their yardage tonight.
Yeah, they'll sweat off a few pounds here.
Here's Even. A clean pass to Mike Million.
Throws for another first down. Good job by Jack Even. We're here at about 1:25 left in the first quarter. The cadets are snapping the ball again with about 4 or 5 seconds knocked off the play clock. There's no time to catch your breath.
Not at all. And a handoff to Taylor. He fights through a little bit and is taken down about the 43-yard line. Just over a minute here, and the cadets will look to obviously convert again. Even to number 9, Lamar Anderson. They're certainly working their way down the field right now.
They are. They're just chipping away at it. I tell you what, it's kind of a fast break offense. Get it and go. Looking over at the cadet sidelines, we'll get a shot of that sooner or later. Maybe not right now, but we've got 4 or 5 coaches all signaling in plays.
Lamar Anderson here again, and he'll look to go at the 10. And touchdown, Lamar Anderson, CBC up.
Flag down.
And it looks like the cadets will start again at the 25-yard line.
Coming back, a bit of a jet sweep on that play.
A holding call.
Offsetting penalties there. It looked like a holding call on the cadets, a face mask call on the Jays. So we'll just start all over. Our cameraman, Alex Somm, gave us a look over at the coaches who will be signaling a play in here just as we speak. It's
looking like an NFL sideline over there.
A bit of it. It's kind of like dancing chickens over there. Who knows what they're saying or which one of them's live, but having a lot of fun doing it.
Even with a bit of a fake and a good look, which is not quite enough. Knocked down out of Mike Million's hands.
Little misdirection play there. X screen, Mike Million coming in from the wideout position for a middle screen. Once Jack had to pump that one once, it becomes a dangerous throw because as soon as the defense gets a beat on that pass, there's a lot of touch on it.
And a fake throw from Even.
I believe that's Rudy Hamilton.
31, Caleb Allen.
You're right.
Ball carrier Caleb Allen for the Cadets.
That was Caleb Allen.
He's taken down at the 12-yard line.
Caleb had two touchdowns last week. I believe Caleb's only a sophomore, and he's already proven himself here on the varsity level.
That's correct. The Cadets taken down again.
Taylor carries the ball to the J-10-yard line.
We see Taylor again pushing for the Cadets.
Alex Vogel, the tackler.
That'll take us to the end of the first quarter here. We'll Riverside it, head down to the other end of the field, and with the Cadets up 6-0, we'll have a chance to punch it in here as we get the second quarter rolling. But before we do, we'll throw it to a commercial. You're watching the Cadet Student Network.
Call State Farm agent and CBC alum Tim Kylo for all your insurance needs. Tim and the State Farm team provide a full insurance review to make sure you and your family are covered at the best possible price. Whether it's auto, renters, home, business, or life insurance, for more than 23 years, Tim has helped his clients manage the risks of everyday life and realize their dreams. For all your insurance needs, contact one of our school's most loyal alums, Class of 77 graduate Tim Kylo at 314-842-4442 or send him an email, tim@timkylo.com. Call State Farm agent and CBC alum Tim Kylo for all your insurance needs. Tim and the State Farm.
And you're back with the Cadet Student Network. We're about to start the second quarter with the Cadets leading 6-0 over the Jefferson City Jays. A good start from the CBC so far. And here's Even again. And he'll hand off to Taylor, who looked to convert, and he's just outside the end zone here. About the 2-yard line.
Maybe enough for a first down, though, on that good second down run.
The Cadets will look to score early here.
Yeah, they're marking it third and short. Third and incredibly short, only inches.
And he's taken down Miles Taylor at the 5-yard line.
Taylor carries the ball. Stop behind the line of scrimmage.
Looks like head coach Scott Pingle wasn't too happy that they didn't go out and measure on that one. Looked like a first down to me. I'm surprised we didn't get a look at the chains. Meinzer will come in, though, attempt a field goal.
Tyler England, the holder. Number 68, Meinzer, the kick.
The field goal will be good for the extra point. Cadets up 7-0.
It's a good job by big number 68, Meinzer, on getting that ball up and through. Even better job at Tyler England. The junior did a great job of handling a high snap and getting the hold down so that Meinzer could put the boot to it. Well, we have a minute here between as the Cadets get ready to kick off, I want to say thanks to all the Cadet Student Network team who made the trip here to Jefferson City with us. Freshman Tristan Baer, senior Devin Cargill, our expert cameraman Alex Somm, John Rolfe, Tony Gambino, Kyle Hunt, Tommy Hartbeck, Josh Williams, all here with us today. Just a few of the very dedicated and just amazing Cadet Student Network crew. In its first year, the Cadet Student Network broadcast over 100 events to over 25,000 viewers. Awesome job by our CSN team. Jack, you were a part of it last year. It's awesome to have you back with us tonight.
And thank you for having me back. It's always good to come back and see the crew and get back on the mic. So happy to be here.
Well, you're doing an awesome job. You can catch CSN anytime at cbccsn.com. And send us a tweet, @cbccsn. Tell us what you think of tonight's broadcast. It's a lovely night here in Jefferson City. I think you got a shot of the sunset here coming back from the quarter break. Again, not too hot. Great environment for high school football. Big marching band, lots of fans here in the stands. We're having a good time.
Couldn't ask for a better night for some high school football here. The Jefferson Jays will be taken down right past the 20-yard line.
Again, great job by the Cadets, holding firm on that front line. They've given up a few small holes, but they've had a really solid game with that Butch Dimovitz defense.
Gunner C here will with the handoff fake. Ooh, and almost an interception there, and there's a flag on the play.
Flag comes in. That's a rough flag. I don't know what our cornerback could have done better on that play. Ball was almost thrown to him.
Rashawn Davis there, number 7.
Well, what can you do? We're in their backyard. We'll play through it.
And the Jays will start at the 35-yard line. The handoff here. And that was number 26, Denzel Wilson.
Big number 44. Again, breaking through the line, making the tackle in the backfield.
Quentin Wynn yet again.
Oh, you going to coin that phrase?
I might.
This guy's in broadcasting school, ladies and gentlemen.
Take that one back to Mizzou with me. And here's C again with the fake handoff. Almost a sack there.
Quentin Wynn and Big Dominique Gatewood breaking through.
Dynamic duo there.
Can't stop these guys.
And the Cadet defense will yet again try to hold the Jefferson J offense. Pass to number 2, Daniel Ellinger, just past the 35-yard line.
Great job by the cornerback, Rashawn Davis. The junior really drove on that ball, made a tackle. Big play on third down, forced the Jays to punt.
We'll have Mike Million looking to return this one. He picks that one up. There's a flag on the play, and he's taken down just at the 30.
Another
really
flag.
Good hands there by Mike Million.
That was a good job by Mike Million. Again, taking a few chances on those punt returns. Don't want to see those too often.
No.
Looks
certainly.
Like this will be another flag on the Cadets. I think I saw a block in the back there on the far side of the field. Going to move us back. Hey, while this penalty is getting marked off, I'm going to take a moment. That's all about me. I just got a text. I heard my 2-year-old, Charlie Walsh, is watching the broadcast. I'm going to say hello. He'll be in bed by the time I get home tonight. So have a good night, buddy. Love you. Charlie Walsh is a big fan of the Cadet Student Network.
Is he?
Yeah, our student staff loves hanging out with him, too. He was out at the football scrimmage this summer and was bossing these guys around better than I can.
Maybe a future member.
That's right. We'll see.
And here's the CBC offense, number 10, quarterback Blake Charlton. Take us to the 31st yard line. And Charlton again. He'll fake the pass, and he's going to run it, breaking one tackle to put the Cadets at the 36-yard line.
Good job by Blake there to scramble around, get a first down on that second and short play. Looked like there was a pump and go there. It looks like we're going to try to hit Eric Carrera on the wheel route. Didn't develop exactly as we had planned. So smart play by Blake to pull it down.
And here's Charlton again, out to Carrera. Carrera with the stutter step, and he's taken down just at the 41st yard line. You know, Carrera's been a player, like I had said before, for the past three seasons. He joined the team first as a sophomore, and obviously, you know, being a huge football fan and former student upperclassman, you know, Eric has always been someone that we've looked to for not only the cadet offense but defense as well.
That's right. He's had a great career on the defensive side of the ball. It was during summer workouts and some 7-on-7 that the coaches tossed him into the wide receiver position and saw how he could really help the team on offense as well. Looks like we have a false start on the cadets, and we'll be moving backward.
To go back to Carrera again, recently we got a list of the different schools that he's received offers from, which include Air Force, SEMO, Western Illinois, and a couple others as well. So it'll be interesting to see where he ends up next fall.
Eric can be a good college player.
And Charlton looked out wide to number four, Kalen Taylor, yet again, which is a little high.
Just out of his reach. Kalen's a little guy, which helps him sometimes hide him from those linebackers behind the big offensive line.
Exactly. 5'7", 160.
Could have used another inch or two on that pass.
And here the cadets at the 35-yard line. Charlton will look to rush. And he's taken down just at the 40-yard line.
Quick shot on the keeper. Brings the ball out to the 40, tackled by Gerlach.
Let's do a fourth and about seven here. Fourth. Looks like the punt team's coming on at the 8-minute mark here of the second quarter.
And they will look to kick off.
And
Dennis Barnes for the Jefferson Jays will look to return this one. There's a flag.
It's like a fair catch. Yet another flag. Looks like it'll be on the cadets. Movement before the snap. I'll tell you what, if there was one weak, you know, that's one area that we're really going to have to tighten up as the season goes on.
You know, obviously we've seen that today. Quite a few. Obviously we're away from home.
You either move or you don't.
Exactly.
That one was on us.
Most definitely.
Five penalties for 50 yards last week. That's more than you want, not terrible. We've probably already had five or six on the cadets here in the first half.
And there's Charlton with the kickoff.
Another fair catch. Great hang time there by Blake. We wound up gaining about 10 yards in field position difference on that penalty. So if they always worked out in our favor like that, we wouldn't mind so much. But
no problem with it.
We're giving away too many yards with the yellow hankies here tonight.
Official timeout. Automatic water break.
And we'll have a word from our Milliken Wright Law firm. When you need an attorney, you want someone you can count on to protect your legal rights. The attorneys at Milliken Wright are here for you. Brian Milliken and CBC grad Chris Wright have fiercely represented the injured and accused in civil and criminal cases in St. Louis metropolitan area for more than 15 years. You can call Brian and Chris at 314-621-0622 or find them online at www.millikenwright.com. Milliken Wright will fight for you.
Chris Wright, one of our great alums, class of 91, I believe. He graduated with our freshman coaches, Coach Chris Maris and Coach Jim Gertis. They tell great stories about Chris's successes on the football field and some stories not cleared for air, you know, in terms of exploits off the field.
I can only imagine.
Chris is a great sponsor of us here on the Cadet Student Network. Just like all of our alums, we get a lot of support from our alumni association, and those get about that in just a second.
Here the Jays will look to advance, and they're taken down just at the 21-yard line.
Short run there by Gunner. Alumni weekend begins with our Hall of Fame dinner, in which we'll induct six or seven new members of the CBC Alumni Hall of Fame, as well as an honorary alumnus, a former teacher. Pause for play.
The Jays will look to advance number two, and it's a safe catch for Daniel Ellinger, and he's taken down by number 18, Sean Boyd, just past the 30-yard line.
That was a nice little play there by the Jays. The defense is really keyed on the run game. They've been shutting it down, but, you know, you can't get lazy. You can't get complacent, and you've got to stick with your reads, stick with your men. Great little pop.
To take notice, a new quarterback, Isaac Rowling is in, number 7. And here's a handoff to number 28, Alan Rodigen.
Ball carrier Denzel Wilson.
And the Jays will start here at the 35-yard line. Just under 6:30 left on the clock, and the Cadets lead 9-0. And yet another flag on the play.
Looks like Rowling's a bit more of a thrower here. He looks just like Gunner, at least from the press box here.
And exactly.
It's hard to, with the red on black jerseys, my buddy Jack and I are having trouble differentiating one number from the next.
The 7 and the 1 is strikingly similar with these jersey colors. The
tricksters down there, those tricksters. And to explain it for our viewers at home, we were just yet another penalty for a dead ball delay of game due to equipment issues. I don't know if a helmet strap broke or if somebody's shoe came off, but if it's possible, the Cadets have been flagged for an equipment infraction.
Almost an interception there.
Pass intended for Bryce Beckley. Number 43, Hunter Robinson on the cover.
I think that was 18 Sean Boyd out there. Am I wrong?
I believe you're correct.
36 Jays.
Good play to break that up.
And the Jays will look to advance here again. Going up against a tough Cadet of defense right now. And a far pass there.
Rolling overthrew his intended receiver. It was a nice ball, actually, right down inside the sideline. It looked like the J receiver got jammed a bit by the Cadet, or else he may have run right underneath that. So
not a bad attempt.
Good play by number 43, our left cornerback.
Rolling, holding the ball.
43, Hunter Robinson.
Looking at a 46-yard field goal here. We're going to have Eric Carrera back deep to potentially return it or just play deep safety. Not a chance.
No good.
All right, so with 6 minutes left, 6:06 left here in the second quarter, turnover on downs. The Cadets lead 9-0. We'll break for a short commercial here, and we'll be back with more Cadet football on CSN.
This is CBC Athletic Director Rocky Strub, and if you know me, you know I love to eat. One of my favorite spots is the Cafe Afton, the home of the CBC Burger. The owner, Craig Smellick, is a huge CBC fan, and he always treats me right. Located on Gravel Road, the Cafe Afton is a great place to stop after a CBC hockey game, or for any occasion for that matter. Just ask my wife. I'm always looking for an excuse to pay Craig a visit at the Cafe Afton.
And Trey Bryant just carried the ball for the Cadets to put them just at the 25-yard line.
Good first down run, 5-yard gain there. To round out our alumni weekend information, we're playing SLU on October 3rd. That's a Friday night. And then the alumni golf tournament is Sunday, October 5th. Alums, come out and support your school.
Again, Taylor taken down, pushing the Cadets offense right along.
Kalen Taylor off the right side. It'll lead to a third and roughly 4 yards. It'll be interesting to see what Coach Pingle and the offensive staff call here. Offensive coordinator Corey Bethany has got a big play to call.
And Charlton in again for the CBC Cadets, and yet another penalty.
I think that's going to be on them, though, Jackie boy.
And you're correct.
All right, we got one. How about that? It does go both ways.
It does. Even away from home. So the Cadets will start here at their own 30-yard line.
It's a big penalty. Gives us a first down. Keep this drive alive. 9-0. 5:30 left on the clock here in the first half.
Here's Charlton. And he'll go wide, and it's dropped by number 8, Trey Bryant.
Ball right in his hands. I think Trey was looking to run before he made the catch. That was a nice toss by Blake Charlton. Blake's dad was an all-state player here for the Jefferson City Jays back in his high school days.
Really?
So it's a bit of a homecoming for the Charltons tonight. Flag down. I think we're just going to record that and play it every 3 or 4 minutes.
Seems to be the fashion here. A fake to Trey Bryan. There's almost a fumble there, and it's picked up.
Charlton covered that ball up. We got a little too slick for ourselves on that sequence. Love the misdirection, hate the fumbles.
And on this offensive line, we do have a lot of newcomers. Again, like Coach Maris had told me before the game, completely changed face of the offensive lineman. We'll come back to that in a minute. Here's Charlton again. Out wide to Carrera, and Carrera almost turns that one over.
We've got a cadet down on top of a J. I hope Eric's okay. They're pulling the players apart. Looks like everybody's all right. Ooh, nope. Carrera stayed down. Dr. Steve Benz, team orthopedist, out to take a look. Great guy. His son went to CBC.
And Carrera seems to be down.
He sure does. It's another instance of looking to run before you make the catch. Hoping maybe that he just got the wind knocked out of him. It was a pretty good hit by the J defender. Came up and stuck Eric pretty strong right there in the gut. That'll knock the wind out of you.
Well, most definitely.
We'll keep an eye on Eric, Jack, but I see that you're rocking a little bling tonight. Is that a state championship hockey ring
that
I'm looking at?
That is the state championship hockey ring. I was I had quite a few buddies, senior friends on the team that talked me into becoming the manager. I was very against it at the beginning. I'm not sure, a little leery of it. It talked me into it, and it ended up being incredible, obviously, winning the state championship. So I figured tonight, coming in town, hey, staying out of town, but coming to see the cadets play
coming
tonight.
Back
a little,
to CBC.
Little good luck for tonight.
Well,
so.
I tell you what, it looks good. You earned it. You did a great job for the team, and that perspective also helped us on CSN. A lot of insights from the bench.
And it was a good time. We had some good coverage down there.
We learned during that state championship ring chit-chat that it was actually Mike Million that was down. He got up and walked off the field under his own power. I think he did just get hit a little too hard. Fourth down punt for the cadets.
And Charlton with the kick.
Big roll. All the way
really good
back.
For the CBC cadets here.
All the way back to the J24. That's a darn near a 60-yard punt. Good for him.
Jays will take over. First and 10 from their own 24.
And just to talk about this CBC defensive outlook, this defensive lineman, the returning players we have, obviously Quentin Wynn that we saw an outstanding performance from tonight. Also Kevin Williams and Miles Taylor.
Three strong players up front. Quick little throw.
And a big hit there from Sean Boyd.
It was. Defensive line, Wynn and Williams, those two bookends at defensive end, both have potential to play at the next level. Two seniors, we're looking for big things out of them this season.
And also a newcomer, Jordan Davis, who's really proved himself thus far this season.
He's played six great quarters so far. It's good to see him rolling through and getting a lot of time on the defensive line.
Here's a look, and they will advance to the 45-yard line for the pass to number six, Jake Pridgen.
Four minutes left to play here in the second quarter. The cadets are running players on and off amidst the J hurry-up offense. We did We didn't clear that last player.
Here's a throw out to number six again. And Carrera will look to throw him out of bounds, and he succeeds in doing so. You know, it's definitely one of Carrera's strong points, being able to just really wrap up those tacklers, and you know, many times snagging the ball from opposing receivers. He's totaled 118 tackles in his CBC career, and obviously he's a player to keep an eye on.
He is a sound tackler. Filled a number of roles for the Cadets last year, moving up to play linebacker when a few guys went down. Good run there on first down. Take it to second and six for the Jays. They've got a little momentum here, closing out the second quarter.
Most definitely. And the Jays here at their own 35-yard line. And a fake handoff, and he'll rush, but he's taken down right there at the 35.
25, Kevin Kirkbride makes the tackle. Up until that point, senior quarterback Isaac Rowling had them, dare I say, rolling? I went up you there.
You did. I'm going to have to search for another one now.
That one's in honor of Mr. Tom Eichwald, king of the pun.
He really is.
If you catch the Cadets' cadet soccer team here on
They're
CSN.
Endless. They're really endless.
And
incomplete there from Roland.
Incomplete. I was waiting for a flag to be thrown. Thankful that it wasn't. Good coverage by Rashawn Davis.
We almost expect it now each time.
You know, at this point, that one was close enough where they almost could have. Maybe they heard us talking about him.
Here's Rowling again. And a fake handoff, and he'll look to advance. Incomplete yet again.
Boy, oh boy, there have been some open receivers for the Jays. Big turnover on downs, though, for the Cadets. If we can milk the clock here a little bit on offense, we'll be able to go into halftime with no points on the board for the Jays. I talked to Coach Butch Dimovitz today, asked him for some keys to the game. He said, don't let them score.
There you go.
And so the defensive coordinator has held true to that to this point. And the Cadets lead 9-0 here with 2:35 left to play in the second quarter. While we have a second, I'm going to say thank you to another sponsor, Guido's Pizzeria and Tapas, right there on the hill. They sponsored our CSN retreat and broadcast meeting over the summer, sent us 9 or 10 great pies. Thank you to Guido's.
Here's the CBC offense again. Taylor getting thrown around a little bit there.
Kaler stuffed his line. And Jack Even back in for this series for the Cadets. See if he can keep him moving just like he did earlier, early second quarter, late first quarter.
And Taylor will run for yardage, and he's taken down just at the 35-yard line.
Taylor on the carry for the Cadets, tackled by Paul Harris. Gain of 2. 3rd and 8, CBC from their own 35.
CBC at their own 35-yard.
We're going to have 3 wide to the right. 1 up top.
And here's Even again. A great pass to number 8, Trey Bryant.
Lamar Anderson.
They tricked you, buddy. The those 8s and 9s really look like each other from up here.
7 and the 1, the 8 and the 9.
CSN's going to invest in some binoculars. That's what's next.
Could use some.
4th down and 3 or 4 to go here. It looks like the Cadets will be bringing on the punt team. The Jays take a timeout as they will look to get the offense moving here before the first half runs out. Jack, what are your thoughts here to this point of the game?
You know, I think so far it's been the Cadet defense that's really kind of held this team together. Obviously, you know, the Jays have been unable to put any points on the board, and I think we have to credit the Cadet defense on that. As Coach Dimovitz had said, don't let them score, and they've done just that. So I think right now the defense is the main talk.
You're right.
Around this game.
Strong play for the defense and the J defense as well. They've after a few quick drives there in the first quarter, they've adapted and. and they've shut the Cadets down the last few times.
Definitely. The Cadets, you know, in the last game were able to score 68 points. So far we've only had 9. So
that's right. Between the J defense playing pretty well and the Cadets hurting themselves with penalties, that's what you get. We've got 4 guys split wide here. Punt formation. Charlton back deep.
Charlton with a good kick there to put the Jays right at the 20-yard line.
I tell you what, Jack, you're an alumni now. I know you were off at college this week, but the CBC Alumni Open was this past Monday.
We had
a great time out at Whitmore Country Club in the Missouri Bluffs. Thank you to Bomarito Automotive and GFI Digital for being the marquee sponsors of that event. They've done a great job. This was the 10th annual, and we raise about $250,000 every year to support the cadet financial aid programs. So thanks to everybody who came out to support us, and thanks to our sponsors.
Great, great defense there by CBC, taking down Rollins just at the 15-yard line.
I think that's Miles Taylor and Kevin Williams sharing that sack.
Second down for the Jays.
Looks like the Jays are going to milk some clock here now that they've pushed back to 2nd and 16.
47 seconds left on the clock. And they'll look to run, but they're taken down just at the 15-yard line again.
CBC uses a timeout now. Force them to run a third down play and see what happens on the punt.
Cadet fans, do you know a grade school student who might be a future cadet? Please encourage them to pay us a visit and experience CBC for themselves. Call Melissa Ryan at 314-985-6095 to schedule a tour of CBC or an 8th grade shadow visit. That's 314-985-6095. Spend a day with us and experience what CBC is all about.
Our admissions team is the best in the business. They do a great job of representing our school. And, you know, there's nothing more important than getting 7th and 8th grade kids into the building. Let them see what we're all about at CBC, all about brotherhood, all about school spirit. There's a really positive energy on campus. Jack, I'm sure you experienced that during your days with us.
It really was. You know, that was obviously my dad was a 84 grad from CBC, so I had a little bit of
he was pushing you that way.
A little bit of push.
All right.
But no, it was the shadowing experience that really kind of turned my head towards CBC and kind of brought me there. Was just the welcoming energy throughout the entire building, staff and students, and it was really incredible. So, you know, now I'm an alumni. So
yeah. Well, you did well for us. Great faculty. Awesome kids on campus. I love being a part of CBC. I've been there about a year and a half now. Wouldn't trade it for the world.
And here's Rollings again, and he'll look to throw.
Ooh. Just out of bounds. Lamar Anderson had a beat on that ball.
He did.
If the field were about 5 yards wider,
would have had it.
May have come down with it. Lamar Anderson on the coverage. Fourth down, 32 seconds left. Looks like we're going to send Kalen Taylor back to field this punt. See if we can't make some magic happen. Taylor back deep for the cadet. Searching the sidelines. Looks like Mike Million's still hanging out with the trainers. Hopefully he's okay.
And here's Taylor. Went almost lost that one there, but was able to recover it just at the 45-yard line.
Doggone. He caught it. He dropped it. Good job by him at jumping on that ball. Cadets will have it in J territory. 25 seconds left in the first half.
Just enough to maybe make something happen here.
I tell you what, with the pace that our offense keeps, you don't need long.
You really don't.
Blake Charlton comes trotting out.
And Taylor to the right of him.
Cameron Curtis out here wide to the wide side of the field.
And here's Charlton. Charlton will look to number 14.
That's Cameron. Good
He's
catch and run.
Down just at the 30-yard line. Again, the Cadets quick offense. 19 seconds left on the clock, still leading by 9.
Clock stops while the chains move.
And here's Charlton. And he'll look to throw with little space, and it's just out wide.
Looks like he had to cut his throw short there. 10 seconds left. The Cadets still have two timeouts, so the entire field's open to him at this point. Still no huddle, even in this situation. We're all hand signals. They've bought in fully to this system.
They really have.
The cadet coaches spent some time at Arkansas State with their football coaching staff to learn the intricacies of running this kind of offense.
So far, it's been going pretty well. And here's Charlton, and he'll be taken down at 36.
The cadets get a timeout in here with 4.6 seconds left. Looks like we're going to run the field goal unit out.
It'll be a 24-yard attempt here.
Timeout, CBC.
And they will use that timeout right here.
Stop the clock, see what Caleb Meinzer's right foot can do for us. Sneak in another 3 points before we go into the half. Ball spotted on the 24, so it's going to be about a 41-yard attempt. No gimme. We'll see what we can do. And hopefully we can shore up the right side of that field goal protection team as well.
Coach Pingle sends Meinzer over to talk to the special teams coach for a moment.
What do you think you tell a kicker in this situation, Jack? Make it?
Don't miss.
One or the other. I think there's only about two things to say.
And that's all you really can. And again, a 24-yard attempt here.
Unless there's a fake in the works. Any predictions?
I'm going to say they play it safe here and go for it.
I agree. I bet we kick the ball.
And it's good.
Looks good. Is good.
Caleb Meinzer.
He crushed that ball. That would have been good from 55 yards. It's not often that you see a field goal kicker wearing number 68.
It's really not.
He put his lineman body behind that one.
Certainly not.
And you're telling me Caleb was a former soccer player?
He was.
Huh?
He was a former soccer player.
Well, he kicks like it.
He really does. And so the Cadets lead 12-0.
There's a bit of a question about the game clock here. There's 0.6 seconds left. And Coach Pingle wanted some explanation as to why the entire time didn't run off the clock during that field goal attempt. I have to imagine that play took more than 4 seconds.
I would hope so.
Regardless, looks like we're going to have a kickoff here.
And Meinzer again for the field goal, or for the kickoff, excuse me.
Meinzer setting up the kick for CBC. Jake Pridgen. Adam Huff back deep for the dig.
Here's Meinzer. And they're taken down at the 25, and time has run out.
There you go. Good coverage by the Cadets. Nice little squib kick.
And we'll enter the third quarter, 12-0, CBC leading the Jefferson City Jays.
We'll go to commercial here. We're at halftime from Jefferson City. You're watching the Cadet Student Network.
Farm team provide a full insurance review to make sure you and your family are covered at the best possible price. Whether it's auto, renters, home, business, or life insurance, for more than 23 years, Tim has helped his clients manage the risks of everyday life and realize their dreams. For all your insurance needs, contact one of our school's most loyal alums, Class of 77 graduate Tim Kylo at 314-842-4442 or send him an email, tim@timkylo.com. Call State Farm agent and CBC alum Tim Kylo for all your insurance needs. Tim and the State Farm team provide a full insurance review to make sure you and your family are covered at the best possible price. Whether it's auto, renters, home, business, or life insurance, for more than 23 years, Tim has helped his clients manage the risks of everyday life and realize their dreams. For all your insurance needs, contact one of our school's most loyal alums, Class of 77 graduate Tim Kylo at 314-842-4442 or send him an email, tim@timkylo.com. Call State Farm agent and CBC.
I know you'll love it too. Please be sure to tell them that you're a CBC fan and that Rocky sent you. That's Cafe Afton, home of the CBC Burger, located on Gravois Road. This is CBC Athletic Director Rocky Straub, and if you know me, you know I love to eat. One of my favorite spots is the Cafe Afton, the home of the CBC Burger. The owner, Craig Smellick, is a huge CBC fan, and he always treats me right. Located on Gravois Road, the Cafe Afton is a great place to stop after a CBC hockey game, or for any occasion for that matter. Just ask my wife. I'm always looking for an excuse to pay Craig a visit at the Cafe Afton. I know you'll love it too. Please be sure to tell them that you're a CBC fan and that Rocky sent you. That's Cafe Afton, home of the CBC Burger, located on Gravois Road. This is CBC Athletic Director Rocky Straub, and if you know me, you know I love to eat. One of my favorite spots is the Cafe Afton, the home of the CBC Burger. The owner, Craig Smellick, is a huge CBC fan, and he always treats me right. Located on Gravois Road, the Cafe Afton is a great place to stop after a CBC hockey game, or for any occasion for that matter. Just ask my wife. I'm always looking for an excuse to pay Craig a visit at the Cafe Afton. I know you'll love it too. Please.
Got random alums who I, some old men, class of 58.
Really?
You're doing great. Global only 19? Wow. You're going to get the business.
Love it. And we're back on the Cadet Student Network, bringing you live here from CBC, or from, excuse me, Jeff City.
Atkins Stadium.
As CBC football takes on Jefferson City Jays. Right now the score is 12-0 as the CBC Cadets start up the third period.
Cadets will get the ball first here in the third quarter after deferring on the opening coin flip. Great first half by the Cadet defense. Good first half by the Cadet offense. What do you think, Jack?
You know, I think, like you said, and we had said right before we went to halftime break, I think the Cadet defense has been outstanding tonight, but I think we almost need to look for a little bit more from the offense, maybe a little bit more production. Receivers out wide maybe need to be a little more open and just a little more conscious of their surroundings, I think.
Catch the ball first, right?
Exactly.
A few drops there in the first half.
By all means.
Just more consistency across the board with the offense. Less penalties. They did a good job moving the ball. Didn't finish on every drive, though. And the scoreboard tells a story. They've scored 12 points. It potentially could be a lot more. We could be talking about 24, 27 points at this point. So good, not great. The Cadets are down there getting warm. Tristan, our cameraman, has the camera positioned on him perfectly. Let's get those high knees going, boys, and let's get ready to play another half of football.
And fans, we want to remind you that CSN is about more than just athletics. We will once again be delivering theater performances, academic events, and other school activities right here at cbccsn.com. Be sure to log on all school year to check us out. From the schoolroom to the court, from the field to the stage, if it's happening at CBC, you'll find it on CSN.
That's right. CSN is about so much more than just athletics. As I said in the first half, more than 100 events in the first year of the Cadet Student Network last year, and a lot of those were theater, fine arts performances, chorus performances, Band of Brothers performances, as well as some academic award ceremonies.
Graduation,
that's right. We did a Live Aid performance, a charity and service event that our Office of Ministry and Mission puts on. It's really all-encompassing. It's all about showcasing the student life there at CBC, and showing people what we're all about, keeping our alums connected. I got a few texts on my phone, checked it during halftime. A few alums, some from the class of 58, our alumni director, a few people in our admissions office, all telling you, Jack, what a great job you're doing here tonight. Nobody can believe that you're just a freshman in college. I tell you what, no compliments coming my way, though. What the heck?
Well, I think that's just given. I think that you're the expert.
That's it. It's just assumed that I'm going to do an awesome job.
Of course, I think that's it.
You're shocking the world here tonight, though, buddy.
I don't know about that, but thank you, guys. I appreciate it. So
it's great having you. So what do you think, Coach Pingle here, moving into the second half, what do you think he said to his team at halftime, and what do you think about his career here at CBC so far?
You know, I think what he's saying tonight, right now, I think is, pretty similar. I can imagine it's pretty similar to what we're talking about right now. Good job on defense. Offense needs to, pick up the slack a little bit right now. But as far as Coach Pinkle, I had him as a math teacher my senior year, my favorite teacher, one of my favorite teachers my senior year, along with Mr. Maris. But he's entering his sixth year as head football coach of CBC High School, and, what a job he's done so far. Taking the team to state championship, consecutive years, and it's really been just kind of almost continuing that same winning tradition that CBC football has always had. So, he's certainly taking us in the right direction and continuing to do so.
Coach Pingle's doing a great job, and I'm interested to hear about Coach Pingle in the classroom. I hear he teaches like he coaches. Does he? He's got a loud, booming voice there in the classroom?
That southern draw a little bit really started to keep you awake. It certainly did me my senior year, and all joking aside, he was one of my favorite teachers, along with Mr. Maris. Both helped me through math this year, and gosh knows I needed it.
That's awesome. So. Well, the Jays kick off here to start the second half. It's going to be a touchback, so the Cadets will start on the 20-yard line.
And make sure you follow CSN on social network. You can look us up on Facebook at Cadet Student Network or on Twitter at CBCCSN. They'll be live tweeting throughout the game. So if you're unable to tune in, make sure you check us out on Twitter if you're busy or at a different sporting event throughout the whole school year. The Cadets here.
Blake Charlton breaks
free. Blake Charlton, he's going. to the 30, and he's taken down by a great tackle at the 25.
The big
incredible
junior,
run right there.
The big junior can run.
And you saw that speed right there that everyone's been talking about, and it was really incredible.
That's right.
6'3", 190. It's got to be hard to catch him. And the Cadets will start here at the 25-yard line. Charlton out wide to number 9.
Lamar Anderson
going
to get in the
end zone. He's going in for a touchdown. Touchdown CBC, 11:36 in the third quarter.
Look at that, Jack. You know, all we did was talk about how the offense needs to step up a little bit. Maybe they were tuning in to CSN during halftime.
I think they might have pulled it up on the sideline.
That's my guess. And here, before 20 seconds are off the clock in the third quarter, we've already got a touchdown.
Minds certainly are on. A great start to the second half right now.
Minds are on for the extra point.
And it's good. So the Cadets will lead 19-0 with 11:36 left to play in the third quarter.
And as we start the second half, I want to say thank you again to the presenting sponsor of the Cadet Student Network. That's CBC alum Tim Kylo, class of 77. Be sure to call Tim, State Farm agent. Call him for all your insurance needs. And he's more than just the best insurance guy in town. Like I said, he's the presenting sponsor of everything you're listening to here on CSN. Thank you for your support, Tim. Give him a call, 314-842-4442, or send him an email, tim@timkylo.com. That's Tim at TimKylo, KILO.com.
And Meinzer will kick off here again. And a good kick, and it'll be returned by number 14, Adam Hoff, and he's taken down right at the 25-yard line.
Good job by Brent Bledsoe, sophomore, 5'8", 140, getting in there to make the special teams tackle. It's not too often that Meinzer doesn't kick it through the end zone, so it's a good job by the kickoff cover team to get down there and make a tackle.
And again, one of those younger guys, newer faces that is stepping up, just as Coach Pingle mentioned, that we're going to see a new faces on this football team that are stepping up and rising to the occasion. A fake throw handoff there, and the Cadets will take the J offense down right at the 30-yard line. Fixing of the jersey there for the J running back.
It's interesting. We got a delay of game penalty called for our equipment malfunction in the first half.
A little questionable there. The fake handoff and an interception.
It's Sean Boyd.
And he'll run it.
Boyd's going to take it to the house.
And it's in for another CBC touchdown.
Big play by Sean Boyd. Rowling pulled that ball back, was looking for the handoff, went for the slant instead. Sean Boyd wasn't fooled by it, pulled it down, took it to the house.
And we want to talk about an offensive turnaround right there. You know, this second half has certainly been just that.
Putting points on the board very quickly here.
And again, Meinzer to a familiar Meinzer spot. As he'll go for the extra point here. And it is good.
Just gets it through. Sean Boyd, great play by the senior, 5'8", 160. Also plays some on the offensive side of the ball at wide receiver. You know, we hear a lot about Damian Baker, Eric Carrera. Sean Boyd is a talented athlete, and he's got next-level potential as well.
He really does. So the Cadets lead 26-0 with 10:55 on the clock left in the third quarter.
Wow. Wild and crazy. Don't know what to say right here, Jack.
That's we've
outscored ourselves from the first minute and 5 seconds of the second half as compared to the entire first half.
Like I said, an absolute turnaround right here offensively for the CBC Cadets.
It'll be interesting to see how the Jays adjust and come back from this. They look a little shell-shocked on the sidelines. They came out with a lot of energy in front of a big home crowd here tonight. Very pumped up in the first half. And they were able to bounce back from the early Cadet touchdown in the first half. We'll see what they can do here on offense to try to respond to the Cadets' two quick touchdowns here to start the second half.
And Meinzer again with a kickoff from the 40.
Little pooch
and
kick.
He'll send a short one.
Fair catch by number five,
Bryce Beckerly.
On the J25
yard line. First and 10, Jay.
Cadet defense comes trotting back out.
Quarterback Isaac Rowling, and he's taken down right at the 25.
Big tackle by Big Baby Miles Taylor, 36 now comes out of the game as 99 Dominique Gatewood comes back in to fill that nose tackle position. 23 Clayton Stalling was also in on that stop.
Ooh, a handoff there. And he's knocked out of bounds right at the 35-yard line.
The 30-yard line of Jeff City. Hunter Robinson, the tackler.
Hunter Robinson with the tackle there.
From their own 30.
Hunter's stepping in and playing where Damian Baker was last week. Doing a good job here tonight.
It's third down for the Jays at the 30-yard line. Here's Rowling, and he'll look to go deep here. And a little too much on that one.
Pass intended for Bryce Beckley.
Hunter Robinson again holding his mark tight there on the right side.
Hunter's having a good day. And we're seeing it here. The Jays aren't able to respond to the two quick touchdowns for the Cadets.
They really aren't. It was almost just really kind of a gutting for the Jays right now.
It's good to see Mike Million back in the game. He's back deep to receive this punt. He went out with an injury there in the first half, but it looks like he's all right.
And we'll see on this return right here.
Think he learned a lesson there?
I think he might have.
Called for a fair catch.
And the Cadets will pick it up at the 33-yard line. And again, here comes the CBC offense, and we'll see, you know, what they have again. They might surprise us yet again.
Jack Even trotting back into the game. Kind of on a 2-1 or 3-1 rotation between Even and Charlton. Both of them are having good games.
A fake handoff to number 87.
I think that's Jack Orban, the tight end.
And he'll continue to go so. Excellent blocking there, and it's a touchdown by number 87, Jack Orban.
The senior just rumbled down the field.
6'1", 225, just barreling down that left side.
He's a big boy.
And the Cadets will go for the extra point to make it 33-0.
Cadets are making it look easy here in the second
half.
They
really are.
Boy, oh boy, I hope the Jays aren't packing it in already because no, they played a strong first half, really competed well. But these last few offensive plays from the Cadets have really picked apart the Jays' defense.
They've really been ruthless so
far. No problem at all.
CBC fans, advertise your business on the Cadet Student Network. Sponsors like Tim Kilo at State Farm, Athletic Republic, Guido's Pizza, and Tapas make this broadcast possible for us. Winter sports packages are now available, including signage, recorded commercials, in-game announcements, and more. Contact Assistant Athletic Director Tony Kosciolek at 314 315-6046. Don't miss your opportunity to reach thousands of loyal fans. And again, that's 314-985-6046.
Darrell Williams.
Taking any and all advertisers here on the Cadet Student Network. This operation is completely funded through advertisers and donations. Big thank you to everybody who has bought in and believes in us. You hear us talking about Tim Kylo quite often. There's also Milliken Wright. There's also Guido's Pizzas and Tapas. The Lab Gym, a great exercise facility on Manchester Road, recently just signed up for a sponsorship. We really appreciate everybody's support.
And again, another short kick here.
Good stick by Mike Million.
And he doesn't seem to be...
He's giving them out
whatsoever.
Now.
Exactly.
He's tired of getting
he's
hit.
Returning
he's
gonna, the favor.
He's going to hit a few folks.
Certainly. So the Jays will look to advance on offense here at their own 30-yard line. Handoff here. And Jay offense is taken down just at the 35-yard line.
The ball carrier for Jeff Setti brings it up to the Jay 35. Clayton Stalling, the tackler.
Clayton Stalling there with the tackle. He's really stepped up for the CBC defense, especially this, you know, in the first half. The Jays will gain a little bit of yardage there.
Third and short. We'll talk about it again. This is an important first down for that Jays team. They need to get a little bit of momentum, win the sidelines back, get this crowd back involved. 33-0 here. This game got away from them quickly.
Handoff there really puts them down.
They get stacked up.
That CBC defense is just not allowing anything through at this point.
Playing well. I saw Alec Wardenberg in that pile. I saw number 5, Mike Jones, in that pile. Mike Jones, another incredibly talented athlete. We haven't talked much about him yet. Wardenberg and who's his counterpart there? Kirkbride. A couple of great linebackers. CBC defense is playing tough.
They really are. And the Jays will kick off here. Mike Million with the fake to the left. And he's taken down.
Gained a few yards on that return.
Not too bad.
Tried to put a little bit of shake and bake on it.
Cole Hybrider in on the tackle for the Jays.
Thanks to everybody who's tuned in so far here tonight. We've had a great response to the game. We were looking at analytics during halftime. Looks like we've had up over 400 people tune in so far. And we really appreciate the support of our viewership. Josh Williams, one of our station managers, is over here working social media, taking a look at the YouTube live stream. How we doing, Josh? Josh says we're doing well.
And if I'm not mistaken, it looks like we have somewhat of a student section over there going on. A couple of the guys lined up by the fence made the trip out from town and country.
I tell you, there's no stopping the cadet crew, buddy.
There really isn't.
Best fans in the land.
Continuing on the solid tradition that we had last season.
Are you trying to take credit for what's going on here?
You almost have to a little bit. As
hey, our alums take a lot of pride in the school. We
most
love that
definitely.
About the place. As I was saying earlier, the school spirit and the sense of brotherhood is the real deal. It's what I've enjoyed most about my time at CBC, and our fans are into it. They'll make the 2-hour trip just to watch their team play, and they're pleased tonight. Hand off to Kalen Taylor.
Taylor taken down at the 30-yard line.
Dragging tacklers for that 4-yard gang.
Travis Burris on the tackle. Second and 6.
Taylor really ripped apart there.
Kaylin Cherry. Taylor carrying the ball. Paul Harris on the tackle.
Orban goes off. Number 9, Lamar Anderson, checks into the game. Surprised Orban isn't still on oxygen after that long run.
I'll tell you what, he was really hauling it down there.
That's the longest catch and run I've ever seen Jack have.
Here's Charlton, just short.
Quarterback and receiver were not on the same page in that instance.
Not at all.
Number 14, senior Cameron Curtis, was running a go. Charlton had him running a stop. All of a sudden, we've got a fourth down on our hands.
Charlton setting up the punt on the fourth
down for CBC. Zach Bond I'm going to give a shout out to a good snap from long snapper, sophomore Benji Gormley.
Great tackle there by number 85, Benji Gormley.
That's my guy. I was just calling his name. You know, Jack, I was a long snapper.
Were you?
A long time ago, huh, punny? And you only get recognized, people only call your name when you screw up at that position. So I'd like to give a little love to the guys who have to throw the ball 15 yards through their legs. Rightfully not so easy.
No, it's not.
Not so easy.
I dare the people listening to go try it.
I'll challenge you after this game. We'll venture down to the field, see what you can do.
That could be questionable. Make sure we're off air when that happens.
No promises.
Here's the J offense.
Throws it to nobody.
7:09 left, and the Cadets are leading 33-0 in the third period. Third quarter, excuse me.
This isn't hockey, Chief.
Mind on hockey, I'm telling you what. Blue season is right around the corner.
Blue season is right around the corner. Did you see those new jerseys
out
the other
day? Love it.
You love it?
Throwing it back towards like the 2005 era, I can dig it.
I like it. It was a big hullabaloo over a small change,
well,
in my opinion.
I agree. They made quite the hype out of it.
Well, for you hockey geeks, I'm sure.
We love it.
I'm sure it was a special Monday.
We love it.
Can't wait to watch cadet hockey again this year. Hope you get back in town for a game or two, Jack.
Most definitely. My roommate actually at CBC, I'll give a shout out here, David Hibbard, who's down and actually head back to St. Louis today to see the family. And so we already have a plan to come back over the Christmas break and watch some of the games. I think they have a game. They usually have a game against a big MCC school, hopefully SLU or Slew to Smet, so we'll be able to make it back for one of those, but most definitely looking forward to it.
The Afton Ice Rink is rocking most Friday nights, isn't
Always.
It?
Always. It's the place to be. And the J offense is taken down again.
Yeah, they're going nowhere. They're going there
really
fast.
Really not, no. You're not missing much here.
Let's just get back to talking hockey. I saw Coach Jost out at the alumni golf
Did
tournament
you?
On Monday. Love that guy. CBC alum. The guy's won more state championships than he has fingers for rings.
I'll tell you what, he does. And actually, we were talking about the rings earlier. We got our rings about the middle of June.
Mm-hmm.
And obviously, they're incredible. But got to see Coach Jost one last time before we headed off to school. And we all promised we'd come back and catch some games. So.
That's awesome. Great year by that class of 2014 senior class. And by everybody involved in the hockey program last year. It was a lot of fun to be a part of, to get to watch, and a lot of well-deserved attention to that squad. The J punt goes down to the cadet 28-yard line, which is where CBC will start this next drive. Charlton comes trotting back out. And just one more hockey plug. I don't talk CBC hockey without mentioning Randy Staub's name.
The Stobber.
Mr. Staub is a stud in the classroom, and he's an awesome hockey coach as well.
Exactly.
And here we go. I think that's Lamar Anderson with a catch and about a 20-yard run. And the Cadets don't stop, even when you're up 33 in the third quarter.
They really haven't let down, which is, you know, really kind of, I think that speaks volume about this offense and that turnaround after that somewhat of a slow first half.
Mm-hmm. Go, go, go. That's 31, Caleb Allen. Sophomore getting some time here.
Not a bad run. Again, one of those guys really kind of stepping up. And it's almost games like these in any sport where, you know, you're really running the scoreboard, and it gives those guys who are, you know, whether it be underclassmen or backups, really an opportunity to kind of shine and show their stuff.
Absolutely.
Here's Charlton. And he'll look to number 14. That's Cameron Curtis. Knocked out of play just before the 40, just before the 35.
Cameron Curtis having a great year so far.
He really is.
He was one of those role guys, one of those backup players last year. One of the best dressed guys on campus. I know as a small business owner, Jack has a fashion line here. I'm sure he appreciates the way Cameron can dress.
Oh, definitely. And here we go.
31, Caleb Allen.
And he'll look to take it all the way, and he's brought in.
Look at that.
For another CBC touchdown.
Touchdown, CBC. Caleb Allen drags a Jefferson City J into the end zone with him. It looked like that kid wasn't very interested in making the tackle, unfortunately.
It really wasn't.
Caleb Mines are on. This would make it 40-0 Cadets if it goes through.
And it's good.
There you go. So with 5:27 left in the third quarter, the Cadets lead 40-0. We've already scored 28 points.
Unbelievable.
Here in this third quarter.
It's really incredible.
And a nice cool breeze is starting to blow through the booth as well.
We were a little worried, about rain there, but
turned into a lovely evening.
Exactly.
And we just had a slight tripod malfunction, so we're sorry for any seasickness that any of our viewers just experienced.
It must have been that slight wind.
You know what? I'm gonna blame the freshman here who's taking over the camera for the third quarter. Just kidding, buddy. You're doing a great job. Tristan, one of our St. Charles guys here with the Cadet Student Network team. A lot of our school now come from St. Charles. What area did you live in, Jeff?
I was a West County guy. I'm from Baldwin.
Is that right?
So, yes.
More than 30% of the school is now St. Charles zip codes. It's a growing part of the city,
it really is.
It's awesome to see so many of these guys coming to CBC.
And that one's kicked out of bounds and will receive a penalty. So the Jays will gain a little bit of yardage here.
I think that kick out of bounds, I think that puts us at either 35 or 40. I'm not sure.
It looks like it's going to be the 35,
35-yard line.
The Jays will take over at their own 35-yard line. First down, Jays.
So the defense is pitching a shutout. Let's see if we can't keep a goose egg up on the board and make
so
a...
So far, it's been full circle now with the offense really picking up this second half.
Yeah.
There's the J offense here, and a big tackle there. Wow.
That's number seven, Rashawn Davis. Really driving on the ball. He may have rung his own bell on that one. Slightly slow to get up. He comes off, and number nine, Lamar Anderson, comes in to spell him. He deserves a playoff after that
definitely.
Hit.
Definitely. The Jays on their own 33 right now. Second down, 4:54 left to play. And no such luck on really any advancement here.
Rolling had to work hard to get back to the line of scrimmage. It's going to leave the Jays with a 3rd and 12. And with the way the pass game has gone for Jefferson City tonight, that's a tall hill to climb.
It really is. Rolling here with the fake handoff. He'll look to go a little deep, but it's short.
That play had a chance. Play action, a little wheel route by the running back. Rolling's throw was about 5 yards too short, though, and brings up a 4th and long.
Coming out the front, JT Fulton.
And Mike Million will be back for this one.
Yeah.
kick to Million. Little stutter step, and he ditches one of them and almost beats another. He's taken down the 33-yard line.
Tackled at the CBC 32-yard line by Cole Hybrider.
So the CBC offense will look to advance yet again with 3:10 left on the board as they lead 40-0 in the third quarter.
That's Trey Bryant.
And he'll continue to go at the 30, 20, 10, and he's in for a touchdown. Cadets score yet again.
Trey Bryant, the junior, big run there, ran away from everybody. He's one of the fastest guys, not only on our campus, but on any campus. He was at a few high school combines this summer. I believe he clocked one of the fastest 40 times.
And he's actually coming off of injury this year. I believe it was a knee injury. And what a return he's had.
Yeah, sidelined him for the entire season last year. Didn't get to strap on the pads, but he's had a great first two games here in 2014.
Here's Meinzer for yet another good field goal.
So the Cadets are ahead 47-0 with 2:40 left in the third quarter. We're going to step away for just a second, but we'll be back on the Cadet Student Network.
Caleb Meinzer here for the kickoff. And he'll send it into the end zone again.
Jays will take over at their own 20. First down, Jays.
So a familiar scene here for the Cadets as the defense trots out for a Jeff City Jays first down on the 20-yard line. We're seeing some new players roll through here. It looks like some of the second-team defenders are out there. Jordan Sittner.
And mixed in with some of the veterans, Eric Carrera out there as well. Carrera there with the attempt to tackle. Just missed him.
Nice little move by Pittman.
Most definitely.
The Jay running back. Carrera went low, and Pittman just slipped away from him. Good team defense, though, by the Cadets.
So the Jays pick up a first down here on the 41-yard line. And they're taken down.
Saw number 13, Jeremy Strong in there. Number 20, Alec Wardenberg in there. And the big nose tackle. Sittner also helped clog up that hole.
A big tackle there from number 3, Gavin Burks. Again, another younger guy stepping up and making tackles, making plays.
Good tackle by the sophomore.
There'll be a flag here. Thank you. So the Jays on a third down here at the 43-yard line. Just under 50 seconds left to play in the third quarter. And that'll be thrown wide and out of bounds.
Pass intended to Jacob Gorley. Brings up a Jay fourth down at their own 43.
25 seconds left to play. Cadets up 47 to nothing. And the Jays will kick it off.
High spiraling kick. The Jeff City Jays punter might get player of the game.
Really?
CBC will take over at their own 11-yard line.
We'll start the fourth quarter with the Cadets leading 47 to nothing. We'll flip this field around, and we'll be right back after these words from our sponsors.
Tim Kylo for all your insurance needs. Tim and the State Farm team provide a full insurance review to make sure you and your family are covered at the best possible price. Whether it's auto, renters, home, business, or life insurance, for more than 23 years, Tim has helped his clients manage the risks of everyday life and realize their dreams. For all your insurance needs, contact one of our school's most loyal alums, Class of 77 graduate Tim Kylo at 314-842-4442 or send him an email, tim@timkylo.com. Call State Farm agent and CBC alum Tim Kylo for all your insurance needs.
Be sure to tell them that you're a CBC fan and that Rocky sent you. That's Cafe Afton, home of the CBC Burger, located on Gravois Road. This is CBC Athletic Director Rocky Strub, and if you know me, you know I love to eat. One of my favorite spots is the Cafe Afton, the home of the CBC Burger. The owner, Craig Schmelick, is a huge CBC fan, and he always treats me right. Located on Gravois Road, the Cafe Afton is a great place to stop after.
I'm not sure what the running clock rules are, but I believe we'll be under them as we see 12 minutes on the clock. The Cadets lead 47 to nothing. Charlton back at quarterback.
And a handoff to Taylor here. And he'll put up a good fight, but he looks like
Taylor
he's
carries the ball for the
thrown around there a little bit.
Isaac Templeton, the tackler at the
we're also seeing number two, Rudy Hamilton, in the game at running back. Everybody gets a chance to play tonight.
Charlton here, and he'll toss wide.
I think that's Mike Million.
And he's pushed out of bounds.
Million, the receiver, forced out of bounds by Isaiah Sand. Ball being spotted at the CBC 28.
Seeing
down.
Some of the backup offensive linemen on the field as well.
Definitely.
I think I caught a glimpse of 79, Patrick White. 74, Justin Lewis. Get everybody mentioned if we can.
Million there. Excuse me, Taylor.
Jalen Martin on the tackle.
10:36 left on the clock. Charlton there with a little run game. And the Cadets stand at the 33-yard line, third down.
Jack Bertolucci, the starting right guard, has bumped over to center. It looks like he takes some snaps at center as well. Jack, the senior, is coming up big for the Cadets this year after, again, not getting as much playing time last year as I'm sure he would have liked with all those big seniors up front. Charlton, have at it, Jack.
Charlton there with the failed attempt to go out wide to number 80, Ryan Scott.
Blake Charlton setting up the kick for CBC.
Junior, 6 foot, 165 pounds.
Zach Bond back deep to the Jays.
Well, we've got a new punter in the game, Caleb Meinzer. Not only does he kick big field goals and kickoffs, let's see how far this one goes.
He's doing everything tonight.
Barely got that one off. Covered up by number 23, Clayton Stalling. During this short break in the action, I want to say thank you again to all the CSN sponsors. Not only do we have sponsors from off campus, businesses and restaurants and folks who believe in what we're doing here at the Cadet Student Network, we've also got some investment from people on campus. Our admissions team has invested in this group, really likes what these students are putting together and making happen for our school, as does the SLC, the athletic department, the theater and performing arts crew. So thank you to everybody involved, especially you, Jim Brockman, who I got a text from just about 5 minutes ago.
And the Jays stand on the 37-yard line, second down.
Who's in at quarterback now? Number 10, I think, J.T. Bolkin.
And he'll throw a little bit too deep there.
Well, with this running clock, the fourth quarter will go more quickly than the first three. We're okay with that. We got a long drive home tonight, Jack.
Oh, we do. Number 35, Wilsdorf coming in.
And as a player or as a broadcaster, this is my first time in the booth, but it's about this time of the night where I start wondering about what's for dinner.
Headed back to beautiful Columbia, I might have to make a stop through Shakespeare's if it's not too
late. Shakespeare's, look at that. Throwing out the college spots.
Trying to get a sponsorship going.
That'd be nice. Well, you being the head of our Columbia office, I'm going to put you in charge of that account.
I'll make sure we get something going there.
Yeah, you better show up. We'll have run our sales reports at the end of the month, and if we don't have anything coming out of your office, well, I'm going to have to have a stern talking to with you.
Most definitely. The Jays will kick off here. Mike Million waving it off.
Another beautiful kick, and that is number 10, J.T. Bolkin. Got a few snaps at quarterback, but I tell you what, he's my, if I'm starting a team, he's my punter.
Oh, most definitely. And after numerous requests, I have to give a shout out to Andrew Knight, CBC senior, who's been blowing my phone up asking me to put his name on the air. I think he might be looking for Twitter followers, but it'd be a mistake if you follow him. So
yeah, I don't think we'll throw that handle around. But hello, Andrew. Glad you're tuning in this evening.
Yeah, thank you for tuning in and following us on Twitter as well.
And I tell you what, Andrew Knight and the rest of the cadet crew will be at the CBC Mixer this Sunday night, as we've got a new quarterback in for the Cadets. That's the sophomore, number 16, and he's going to run. Oh, they pulled him down.
Brandon Douglas
had a good year last year on the freshman team. Led that team to a lot of success. I can't remember if they went undefeated or not, but they didn't lose many games, if any. But back to the CBC Mixer. Freshmen, sophomores from CBC and any other school, be at CBC this Sunday night. The SLC sponsors a mixer. It's a big fundraiser, and it's one of the best times you'll have here as we kick off the school year. I know a lot of our CSN guys will be there working, and as will the cadet crew. And be there or be square. How old am I? Is that the best I can come
I
up with on that
you're,
one, Jack?
You're giving away your age on that one.
Yeah.
No, but in all honesty, the mixer is quite the popular event.
Place to be.
It is, really.
Get there early. The lines will be long. CBC Mixers has their own Twitter account.
They do.
At CBC Mixer, I think.
Along with the cadet crew, you can follow them as well to keep updates. I believe they're doing always live updates on the games and scores and such, along with updates on themes and anything like that. So,
that's right. At Cadet Crew. At CBC Mixer, at Cadet Head, our mascot, has its own Twitter account.
really stepping it up in the Twitter sphere.
Hey, social media, baby. It's the wave of the future. Follow us at CBCCSN as well. Just don't follow Andrew Knight.
That would be a good decision. Student Leadership Council as well at SLC.
At CBC
SLC.
There you go.
And a handoff to number two, Rudy Hamilton. And he's taken down just past the 40.
Gerloff on the tackle at the 43. Check that 42.
All right. The clock keeps ticking here. We're at 3:49 left in the fourth quarter. Here from Jefferson City, you're watching the Cadet Student Network. The Cadets lead the Jefferson City Jays 47-0. It was 12-0 at halftime. The Cadets came out and scored two touchdowns within the first 2 minutes of the third quarter. It was all downhill from there for the Jays.
It really has been.
And now we're just trading punts back and forth, and everybody's ready to go home. Like I said, at this point of a blowout, you know, back when I was on the field, I was wondering about what the team meal was going to be. You know, are they getting us pizza or burgers on the bus after the game?
Long bus. It's either a great bus ride home or if you're on the losing side, it's a long one.
That's right. Lucky for us, the Cadets will be happy as they head back to St. Louis tonight. Practice. I believe the players will have the weekend off. Start practicing on Monday for a big showdown next Friday night against Fort Zumwalt West. Zumwalt West beat the Cadets in the first game of the year last year, so this will be a bit of a revenge game for the Cadets. And Zumwalt West is a good team this year. I know they're ranked in the top 10, I believe, in the metro area.
Yeah.
So we're excited for that one.
And a handoff here from the Jays, but it's taken down by number 21, Ronson Longy.
Big tackle by Ronson. The senior 6 foot, 220. He's a big kid with a big smile. He is one of my favorite people on campus. Run out of bounds there by number 27, Namonte Hawthorne. And we're back where we started on the quarterback hunt for the Jays. Is that Gunner back in the game?
I believe it is. Yes, it is. He's made a return. And a handoff here. But he's brought down by, looks like, what is all of the Cadet defensive line there.
He stopped at the 42-yard line. Second down.
As we move toward the last 90 seconds of the game, I want to say thank you again to all the CSN staff who made the trip here. John Rolfe running the board, Josh Williams on social media, and managing all things YouTube. I see Tony Gambino's in the booth with us for a moment here. Devin Cargill, Tristan, the freshman. I can't remember Tristan's name. I apologize. Tristan Bear, Kyle Hunt's with us. Tommy Hartbeck's with us. Alex Somm, did I say your name yet? Well, here you go. Alex Somm. Working the camera. Great job by everybody tonight. And thank you. Ooh, we're going to get another flag before we get out of here. The Cadets cleaned up the penalties pretty well here in the second half. But looks like we'll get another pass interference call before the night is through. The clock continues to run, though. And there are about 40 seconds left in this game here from Adkins Stadium. Jack Hummel, any final words for us before you head back to college and out of our lives forever?
No, not by any stretch. No, thank you guys again for having me back. It's always good to come back and work with the CSN Cadet Student Network and you know, come back where it all kind of began and where I kind of got the opportunity to explore broadcast journalism, which now I'm seeking a major in. Mm-hmm. So it really kind of started all there for me, especially after retiring early as an athlete. So it was a good thing for me, and you guys kind of helped me do that. So it's awesome to be able to come back. So, and that's a Cadet win, 47-0, over the Jefferson City Jays. A big night for CBC. After a somewhat of a slow start, they were able to turn it around, and now they'll line it up, and the night is through.
Nothing left but the handshakes and the showers. Let's say great job by the Cadets. Looks like the folks here in Jeff City turned the scoreboard off as quickly as possible after that 47-0
win. Probably a wise decision.
The Cadets really came out and played their game here in the second half. Great job by them. Great job by Coach Pingle and his staff for making the right adjustments. And now we'll hit the road, head back to St. Louis, and want to thank the Jefferson City Jays for great hospitality tonight in a beautiful stadium here at Atkins Stadium. I'm Patrick Walsh. Jack, I'll throw it back to you to sign us off.
Thank you guys again for tuning in, and catch us next week as we take on Fort Zumwalt West at CBC. Jack Hummel signing out with the Cadet Student Network.